Yeah, once you start, you can't stop.
Second boss is around here somewhere, Gary. Well, here he is. He's bigger than I am. Wife, Barbie, and his children, my grandchildren, and so on. And daughter Candy hiding back over there. She doesn't hear me, I guess. What I really would like everybody to know that Bud really wasn't a bad guy at all. And I know that's hard for you to swallow, and I don't say it at all tongue in cheek. I say it because he was put in a pretty tough situation. You have to compete to get something that rolls like Mammoth. You don't have what it takes to compete with him. You can't go anywhere but down. He never had the dollars after he got started to make the necessary improvements. And if you just look around the country today, there's over 150 ski areas the size of June Lake that are biting the dust. They're just not cutting. So when Bud comes back to the area, I think that he should have some sort of respect from the community just for keeping it alive so we could take it over. I really do. The man has suffered quite a person, and I can make a lot of mistakes along the way. And, we can always look and say today is a joyous day, and we're all willing to see June Lake grow, but at what speed and how, for what reason, and down the line maybe step on a few people's toes or create a few problems, and then maybe Dave McCoy or Mammoth Mountain aren't so great. My door is always open. I'm an open door policy manager. Anybody can come and see me anytime, say what they want. No matter what they say, good or bad, we can have an understanding, shake hands, and leave, and go each way as friendly as ever. I want you people in June Lake to realize that. We're not going to come in here and destroy things or disturb things or bring big developers or anything like that in to keep up with the fast growth. We want to look at this for gentle growth, strong growth, you people remaining and always being good partners. That's what I look at. The mountain can only grow the strongest base of the mountain. I'm not going to ask for guidance. I just will observe and see what's going on and how you react. If you want to say something, I'm here. And to start with, and it sounds harsh and it sounds fast, but it is only what June is needed to make it acceptable to the skiing community, and that's high capacity lift out of the base, out of the parking lot. Something you can depend on, good quality. We're talking no less than 3,000 an hour from the base to the Michelin. Then we're talking about 2,400 people an hour immediately from there to the skiing area, which up to the Chair 4, which is the easterly side. That gets people out there skiing fast. And then, I don't know how the people look at June Mountain, the slope there that everybody looks at and wishes they could ski down and camp. You can. But if that had a reasonable run that most intermediates and some beginners could get down, would that look like a terrible scar to you, or would it look like
so, go for it.
Yeah, these are things. You know, everybody says, and we have to talk to Lahont, and we have to talk to Forest Service, and you folks in particular. That has to be the first challenge for anybody that's going to open the door. That's the way I look at it, and that's the first big move. So, I want to bring it out really early in the game. There is going to be some face changing on the slope. Anybody like to ask any questions? Shoot.
I think most of us are wondering, will the lift ticket be comparable to what it was before?
I think if we do the things that we talk about doing, have to look at it as to what is the value that the skiers receive. And we played around with the reduced ticket, leave things as they are, only better maintenance, better operations. And would that keep the skier coming? I really don't think so. I think it dropped from 110,000 people a few years ago to 90,000, 70,000, and this year maybe 60,000. And do you want it to keep going down? I don't think you do, and I think if that's what we did, then we could lower the price to $20 and go broke. I think if we give them better facilities than they have at Mammoth, give them equally as good a grooming, so the skiing is as good, that's what a skier really comes for. And then the price would go to the same price as Mammoth, and it'd be interchangeable ticket. It would be easy to take care of. They could start here, finish there.
Don't take that as a criticism.
That's the way I would look at it, Bob.
Yes, Dave, I'd like to ask you two questions. You talked about moving 3,000 skiers an hour up to the mid-chalet. Will that be in effect for this coming season?
That's what we're looking
at. Okay. So you're talking about a gondola at 3,000.
Right now, we're really not talking about a gondola. It's a unique, it's different. It's called a quadratrack. It's a box about 10 feet square, and it holds 20 people. And it's detachable like a gondola. And this will be a first in the United States. It's approved Thursday by the Forest Service and their engineers. It'll go to the state Monday. And Gary does exceptionally well in insurance, and if it's insurable, that's the means that we'll use. It's not as expensive. It's faster. The person will carry the ski in the cabin, stand up, walk in and out. And it's about half the price of a gondola and does a third again more. There'll be roughly 20 cars on the line, seven of them at one time going down, seven going up. They're detachable, and plenty of time to get in and out. We don't know exactly where it'll go, but it'll go clear down to the parking lot. And the base area will have to be well thought out. There'll be no support facilities at the bottom of the hill this year unless we use portable units. And the base of the hill where chair one starts, where the ticket booth is, where the garage area is, and that rock knoll to the east, that'll all have to be moved. We would like to keep the slope, the starting slope, as close to the hill as the bottom of chair one now, if at all possible, for snow maintenance. Get too far out in the flat, it'll burn off. That's going to take a lot of planning and take time, and again, a lot of dirt moving and culverts and being careful with the grip and all that. That's the way we're going to approach that area. Then the upper lift would then start east of the chalet to the left of number two chair, and then go 9,000 feet to the top of chair four. And that would be a capacity of 2,400 an hour, or maybe this year leave it at 1,800. But that would then put the people immediately ski. There wouldn't be a wait for tickets, a wait for the uphill, a wait for the number two lift, and then wait again at number three, 3 hours later. We expect to get them skiing in 20 minutes.
One more thing, Dave. I'd like to, at your leisure, you yourself or your son or somebody else who represents you, maybe have certain community members meet with you. assist to see how we can help the transition and what we can do to work with the Mammoth people as a community. In the past, as you probably know, that we have not been together today with Bud. We would like to extend that to you and work closer to you as a community. So I'm sure one of us will be calling, I think, either yourself or Gary, and maybe try to set up some kind of meeting where we can get together.
I think what Bob's saying, Dave, is that when we all as resort owners start coordinating our programs for this winter, we'd like to work with your people over there in our promotions so that we can help you promote the fact that you have Blue Mountain and what you're trying to do and the fact that we are trying to help our own businesses too. But we'd like to coordinate that with you.
I was going to bring Evan Russell, who's the head of our public relations department.
Make ourselves available for that kind of a meeting to be, you know, let Evan help us learn what
help
you guys
all.
Have already done.
Everybody working together.
Well, I think also, Dave, we're going to have a lot of our customers, the resort people, are going to be calling us and asking us what's going on up there, what can we expect this year, why should we come to you?
That's
the information we need to give.
That's why I'm telling you, those two lifts, seems like a big move and it's a big change, but all it will do is just take care of the needs you have today. Mammoth has to get some people out of it. You might just as well come.
We've got
them. Might just as well come to June. There's no reason.
Is there going to be an extension in the lease season? Is it going to carry after Easter vacation?
That I think is the question that you people have to answer. Is there going to be an extended spring season at June? If the snow's there and the skiing's available, do you want to close the last two or three weeks in April so you can go on a vacation before you start skiing?
Yeah, we've had that
Well, I'm asking because, you know, you get in a rut and you might want to stay there. And I'm not going to force anything on you because Mammoth can well take care of people at that time of year. But if it's a desire to try to do it, we could stay with it. We will. Because people get in the habit. They wouldn't ski on Mammoth if they had to, if they could ski in June. And that's a fact. We have people skiing warming up too that won't go to the main line. So that's one thing, and I'm glad you brought up the public relations because that's the name of the game. We really want to address any questions at any time to that end. And then the next thing is really the tough one, and that is, are we going to bring people from Mammoth to run June Lake? I think that is a lot up to the people in June Lake. If the people that showed the loyalty to Bud and the mountain, we want to definitely respect. We want those people to remain on the mountain. We want to make the best operation we can for those people. And then as we grow, Mammoth will certainly filter in. But there is no danger to anybody that's working there now, and I don't mean this minute, but that have a habit of working there in the wintertime. We still want to take care of those people and honor that. We will certainly give them the direction. I expect to be here quite a little bit. So, any other questions?
I have one.
Two.
I just wondered, are you going to be able to fill the potholes in the park? I get so many complaints over those potholes.
I tell you, when we move in there, there and start working, we might make them bigger. Yeah, that's a good question. I drove through there the other day. And
you actually were able to drive through?
You can get lost in there.
And, really no different than a lot of the roads in Mammoth. Yes, we'll attempt to move them up. We'll also attempt to get another exit road, probably, I would say, at this end of the west end of the parking lot. And we may take away some parking, but maybe we'll make it more convenient to get from town to the ski area. We'll probably have to use some of that parking area that's closer to the base of the mountain.
Are you going to, have you thought about instituting any kind of a shuttle bus system over here?
Well, we'll
think about it.
Take a poll on that one. Insurance, we all know, is a big problem. We had ours canceled on the buses we have in Mammoth about 5 or 6 days ago. Gary says he can get us some more insurance. That's a full-time job. I depend on him 1,000% to keep the doors of Mammoth open, so we just have an extra load. And it makes it better. It gives another place to put it to work. Okay. Yeah?
Dave, are you going to have any snowmaking equipment on the mountain?
I understand the snowmaking equipment's already there.
That's right.
I want to know what Gary was chuckling about.
We'll do everything we can to revive it. I'm not saying we'll have it done this year, but I think there's plenty of water here and the temperature's good. And it's been proven they can make good snow. And I think that would be a lifeline to both organizations. Definitely have snow in the year.
What about the future of the T-bar?
I think the T-bar is a necessary part of it.
How about an extension?
Down over the hill?
Yes.
You're asking me some things about the mountain. I know absolutely nothing about June Mountain. Every time I'd even head this way, the rumors would start flying. Stayed away. But I have been hiking around a lot of the perimeter of the mountain. And, I see some beautiful things, and I think the expansion is unlimited. And in doing so, we would have to have other accesses to the mountain, like Hartley Springs is definitely an area. And Dead Man Creek at the headwaters is definitely an area. I would be looking at that, but that would be so far down the line that June Lake would be so developed and so solid by then that it would pose no threat whatsoever. And, that again, I think, is what we have to talk about, communications. Today, everybody here is seemingly happy. Desirous of us doing things, and as we grow and we do things that you might not think we should be doing because we'll move a little ways from your doorstep, we probably won't be so popular. I think that's the way it happened when we all voted for Reagan. It was great to have an ambitious, vigorous, dedicated, I'm going to do it and do it type of guy. And made a lot of people unhappy. I don't think he'd get the same number of votes today, but that's the kind of person I believe in. And like you say, you want to help me, and I want to come out and help you. That really isn't the way it really works. If I do the best I can for myself and my employees and my guests in the mountain, behooves you to do the best job you can do to take care of your guests on your property the way you want to do it. That's kind of the way that I've been at Mammoth. And as I said before, I stepped in here and the couple of people say, are you for real? And again, I have to say, if I were to walk down the streets in Mammoth, some people might say the same thing, because I'm not a very visual person. I'm on the mountain, I do my job. Whenever it's called on to help the community, I help the community, but I'm not very present. Seldom see, but always things. So I think that's the kind of partner that I would be. And so often you have people that start out chummy and very friendly, and they get kind of hard to tolerate, and we don't ever want that to happen. They'll do a heck of a good job at arm's length.
There isn't any chance of this deal to fall through.
All right, Mark, we stayed there last night till midnight, and we weren't leaving until we got a signature. This is the first time we've ever gotten that.
The signature was at midnight?
Just before midnight.
Happy birthday to you.
We heard it was at 9 o'clock.
We probably started signing it 9 o'clock. Took a lot of time to make corrections. Okay, corrected paragraphs and all that sort of thing. I think Bud is honestly glad to have the burden lifted from his shoulder. And I don't think you could give it back to him. But I was really, really sincere when I said what I did to begin this little talk, that if I were in Bud's position with no more than he had to work with, I don't think I could have done any better. It's tough.
Dave, I just like to say that on behalf of all these people here, that when you called and said what happened last night, that it was almost like somebody turned the floodwaters off and we weren't going to drown anymore.
Yeah.
And I'm proud. You say that some people fall away from you, but you and I have been friends for the 30 years that I've been here. And for those of you that don't know, I mean, Dave started his mountain clear down on McGee Creek, and then he started up at Mammoth with taking people in on a weasel, and then he built the first chair in 1955, chair one. And even though I broke my leg on his chair two in 1959, I never thought about suing him. But we've been friends ever since, and on behalf of June Lake, thanks for coming.
Yes. That is about the greatest pleasure I'll ever get.
Oh, that's a lot of great things.
You and the doctor would.
Thanks a
lot.
I really feel great about coming over here, and I really feel good about it. And to think that we're going to work together and really make something out of it, in that respect, I'll never run or lose the appreciation of the joy of the opportunity to do the job.
Thank you.
This big guy over here is Rusty Gregory. He's the personnel manager for Mammoth Mountain, and I brought him along. They would still have their job.
You hear that, Rusty?
That's right.
I do what he tells me.
Gary, want to say anything?
Didn't say it at all.
Then I talked to him. Okay, well, let's all have fun together.
Right behind the
wall.
Huh? Right now?
I'm upstairs.
Make you horny.